हेलो स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स इन द लास्ट वीडियो जस्ट वी हैव टू स्टार्टेड द फंक्शन पार्ट बेसिक डेफिनेशन ऑफ द फंक्शन वी हैव टू डिस्कस्ड वेयर एज वेल एज द सम बेसिक काइंड ऑफ फंक्शंस ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ मैपिंग वी हैव टू जस्ट रिटन इन द लास्ट वीडियो सो बेसिकली स्टूडेंट टुडे वी आर टू जस्ट स्टार्ट द टेस्टिंग प्रोसेस बेसिकली हाउ द पर्टिकुलर फंक्शन इज टू बी गेट टेस्टेड वेदर इट इज वन वन फंक्शन और नॉट मैनी वन फंक्शन और नॉट ऑन टू फंक्शन और नॉट इन टू फंक्शन और नॉट एंड फॉर दिस पार्ट स्टूडेंट वी हैव टू टेक द सम बेसिक एग्जाम्पल्स ऑल्सो then definitely you have to just clear the definition of each and every part and according to that you have to just check whether the given function is said to be the one one many one into or onto is it to be clear so today we are going to start the testing process of the function any of the function is to be given then how it is to be tested whether it is said to be the one one or not many one or not into or onto or not is it to be clear so basically basic type of functions just we have to return in the last video also so type of functions on the behalf of mapping means you can say that based on mapping we have to return in the last video based on mapping is it to be clear so student we have to see the basic type of functions where we have to write the very first function that is known as the one one function and this is always said to be the injective function also injective function also is it to be clear so the one one function and injective function both are the same similar name so either of the name is to be given there should be no confusion related to the name of the function here either it is said to be the one one or injective function now we will start the theory of this part how the particular function is to be tested whether the given function is said to be the one one or not so basically student there are three most important ways and there are three ways by which we can check whether of the any function is said to be the one one or not is it to be clear so for this purpose let we will start the very first method so just we have to start the very first method by which we have to check whether the given function is said to be the one one or not so the very first method is said to be the suppose one one means what should be the one one student so you can see this example here suppose any of the function is to be written like this 1 2 3 4 and here a b c and d so 1 1 is it to be clear means you can say that one domain element has unique and distinct image this is the basic definition of 1 1 function then according to this definition we have to start at the checking process so basically before that part this part we have to say that what should be the basic definition of 1 1 function part any function is said to be one one function if domain elements you can say that domain elements has unique or distinct image has unique and distinct image in codomain this is the basic definition of one one function you can understand by using this example here student if any of the function is said to be the suppose this function is to be defined from set a to set b like this 1 a 2 b 3 c so we can write the function like this a to b and here f will be written like this 1 comma a this is 2 comma b this is 3 comma c and lastly we have to write the 4 comma d is it to be clear suppose the function is to be written like this now we have to check whether the function is 1 1 or not then the definition says any function is said to be the 1 1 function if the domain element has unique and distinct image means no particular image will be corresponding to the two domain elements we can say that is it to be clear one image has corresponding to the one domain element that image should not be of other domain element is it to be clear so basically student here one one so one is related to the one one is related to the one that's why the name of function is said to be the one one is it to be clear now student in this case easily you can describe whether the given function is said to be the one one or not but suppose some definition part suppose any of the function
which is to be defined from the natural number to natural number, and fx is equals to given as x square, then how we will check? How we will check whether the given function is said to be the 1 1 or not? Then definitely we have to use the certain method. Is it to be clear? Similarly, the second type of function, that should be known as the many one function. That should be known as the many one function. Then what should be the definition of many one function? Just you can say that any function is said to be the many one function if the domain element has some images. Means domain element has some images, but the particular image in codomain will corresponding to the two element of the domain. So you can say that any function is said to be many one function if image in lie in codomain will be corresponding to the two domain element. If image of two codomain, two or more than two domain element is same. Means what we are saying here, suppose any of the function 1 2 3, suppose here we have to write a, b and c, and suppose this image and this particular image, this image a will be corresponding to the two or more than two domain element. Is it to be clear? So you can say that first of all you can decide whether it is a function or not. So definitely student, it is a function because the domain element has exactly one image, but this particular image a has two corresponding domain element. So such type of functions, many one. So these are many one means many domain element as the one image. That's why the name of this function is said to be the many one function. So first of all you have to clarify the definition of the basic part. 1 1 function is what, many one function is what, onto function is what, or into function is what. Is it to be clear? So definitely student, you can just check the basic examples by which we can specify the 1 1 function or many one function. Now this is the certain definition based part, but how we will check and how the process are to be used to check any other function is 1 1, because all the time student, these type of arrow diagrams, these type of mapping is not to be given. Suppose any of the mapping is to be given, then easily on the behalf of definition you can just check. But student, always all the time such type of mapping is not to be provided for the function, and only the basic definition of function is to be written and any expression is to be written. Then we have to check first of all whether the given expression is said to be the function or not according to the domain and codomain, and then after, if any of the given expression written in the equation of x, or you can say that any of the other function you can take, suppose these functions are to be written, then what is the basic criteria by which we can check whether the given function is said to be 1 1? So these type of methods are to be available, and these type of methods generally we want to know here. Is it to be clear? So pause the video to note it down, these definitions. After that we will start the basic testing process of 1 1 and many one. Is it to be clear? Only just we have to discuss the testing process of 1 1. Automatically you can say that the given function is said to be the many one or not, because any of the function is 1 1, then it should not be many one, or if any function is not 1 1, then automatically the given function is said to be the many one. Is it to be clear? So note the each and every part student, that should be written here. Then after we have to start the next testing process. So how to test the 1 1 function? Is it to be clear? Means testing of 1 1 function. Is it to be clear? So definitely student, how to test the, there are three methods. Now we will start the very first method. There are three methods are to be described to check the any function is said to be the 1 1 or not. So we will start the very first method that should be belongs to, means suppose in this case student, what we are saying, a very important concept is to be used here to check the any function is said to be 1 1 or not. So basically for this part we have to declare the first of all function as many one, and after that we have to just prove that it is 1 1 or not. Means the reverse process is to be taken. Means suppose any of the function is to be defined from a to b. Any of the function is to be defined from a to b. Let any function is to be given. So let x1 comma x2 belongs to the set A such that f of x1 equals to f of x2. Means what we are saying, we are taking the two domain element x1 and x2, and suppose this function is to be defined from a to b, and what we are saying that the images are same, means f of x1 equals to f of x2, means just we are declaring this function as many one. This is the declaration of many one. Means assume that the function is many one. You can say that assume that the function is many one. Assume that the function is many one. Is it to be clear? So up to this part, how we can estimate this thing? We are just saying that if any of the function will be defined from a to b, then just we have to take the two different element from the domain, and we are saying that these are the taken such that f of x1 equals to f of x2. Means we are saying that these two elements are have the same image. Is it to be clear? Means this function is said to be the many one. Now after calculation of this part, if according to this situation x1 equals to x2 is to be obtained, then it is said to be 1 1. Then it is said to be 1 1. It is said to be 1 1. Is it to be clear? So student, what we are saying here? We are saying that if any of the function f of x1 equals to f of x2 is to be written, and after solving this part, if we will get x1 equals to x2, then it is said to be 1 1. And if x1 not equals to x2, then it is said to be many one. Then it is said to be many one. Is it to be clear or not? So basically, student, here what we are saying, that if we are getting x1 equals to x2, then it is said to be the 1 1 function. And if on behalf of this process we are getting x1 not equals to x2, then we are saying that this given function is said to be many one. Is it to be clear? Means if we have to declare x1, x2 both same, then this will be one element, and one element corresponding to the one image. And on this behalf of this condition, we can say that this function is said to be the 1 1 or many one. If x1 equals to x2, then we can say that it is said to be the 1 1, otherwise it is said to be the many 1. Is it to be clear? So student, this is the very first method in which we have to declare the firstly function as many 1, and after that we are getting the 1 1 or not. It will depend either we are getting x1 equals to x2 or we are getting x1 not equals to x2, because just we have to establish the relation between x1 and x2. According to that, we have to just check whether the given function is 1 1 or not, or many 1 or not. So basically, we have to discuss the one very important example. Suppose any of the function is to be given from natural number to natural number, and here we have to write fx equals to x square. Is it to be clear? Check whether the function is 1 1 or not. Check whether the function is 1 1 or many 1. Is it to be clear? So just in this particular example, student, we are giving a question where any of the function will be defined from the natural number to natural number, and just we want to check whether the given function is 1 1 or not, and just we are using the above systematic method. Is it to be clear? So in this example, you can just understand this thing, how we will declare the many 1 part and how we will say that whether x1 equals to x2 or not. Is it to be clear? So we are just checking the 1 1 function. So for 1 1, let x1 comma x2 belongs to the natural number. Means from the domain we have to take the two different element such that f of x1 equals to f of x2. So student, this statement is to be common for each and every one cases. Is it to be clear? We have to take the two element. Now this is the domain. Here the domain and codomain both are same, but here from where we are taking the two elements, we are taking the two elements from the domain always. We have to keep in mind this thing. Means these x1 and x2 both are to be taken from the natural number which is corresponding to the domain, such that f of x1 equals to f of x2. Now how this process f of x1 will be there? So this particular definition you can use, means in place of x, if we are using x1, then f of x1 will be x1 square, and here if we are using x2 here, then it should be x2 square. So student, according to the given expression, we have to use the expression here. Means according to the definition of x, fx, we have to first of all replace the x by x1, then we will get the left hand side. And if we will get the x, replace the x by x2, then we will get the right hand side. Now we have to simplify this part. Generally x1 square equals to x2 square is there, then student, we have to write x even equals to plus minus x2. But here just we have to keep in mind, so suppose here x1 square equals to x2 square is to be there, then we have to write x1 equals to plus minus x2. So we have to get this expression generally. But student, here what are x1 and x2? What are x1 and x2? X1 and x2 both are the natural number. So can you take plus or minus or not? Means can you take here minus sign or not? It will depend on the domain. Is it to be clear? So here generally we have to see the calculation, then we can use the plus minus sign, no problem. But according to the domain, we have to take plus or minus, because here x1 and x2 both belongs to the natural number. That's why we can say that x1 equals to plus minus x2 is not fair. Means on behalf of this part, you can say that x1 equals to x2, because x1, x2 belongs to the natural number. That's why we cannot, means x1 equals to minus x2 is not possible. This is not possible here. Why this is not possible? Because student, here you can say that both the numbers are natural numbers. So firstly we have to simplify this thing. Now this expression is to be checked on behalf of the x1 and x2. Is it to be clear? X1 and x2 both are the natural number, and no any natural number will be negative always, you know very well. So basically here we will get the condition x1 equals to x2, and if we are getting the condition x1 equals to x2, then it is said to be 1-1. It is said to be 1-1. Is it to be clear? So this is the basic process, student, by which you can just check whether the given function is said to be the 1-1 or not. Now we will take the one more example to understand this thing in more better way. So pause the video to note it down, then after we will start the next example. A very similar kind of example we are taking. Is it to be clear? And student, you can say that the domain part is the very important section in the testing process of the 1-1 function. So note the each and every part that should be written here. After that we will take the next example. So the next example, suppose we have to take here. Suppose any function is to be given now, this time as real number to real number, and here we have to take the fx equals to x square again. Again the same thing is to be checked, means whether the given function is said to be the 1-1 or not, or many one or not, just we have to check this part. So again we have to use the same theory of 1-1. So we are saying that let x1 comma x2 both belongs to the real number, and real number, which real number is there? The domain part we are taking here, such that f of x1 equals to f of x2. Is it to be clear? So here we have writing x1 square, here we have to write the x2 square. Now student, here you can say that x1 equals to plus or minus x2. Now this plus minus is to be correct or not? This is to be checked on behalf of the domain. What is x1 and x2? X1 and x2 both are said to be the real number. So here student, here you can say that plus sign is to be there, means on behalf of this condition x1 equals to x2, or you can say that x1 equals to minus x2, means both are the correct. So it is many one. Is it to be clear? Because here both are possible. These both the things are possible. Both are possible. Why both are possible? Because
because x1 comma x2 belongs to the real number and real number can be either positive or negative. That's why we can say that this thing and this thing both are to be correct. And student, only the one function is only the case where only you will get this result, not getting this result. Here you are getting both the results, x1 equals to either x2 or either x1 equals to minus x2. In both the cases, we are saying that this function is said to be the many one and this is not said to be the one one. Or you can say that suppose any of the real number minus 2 is to be taken and suppose the function is to be defined from this a to b, and here any of the real number and according to the definition minus 2 square is 4, and you can say that 2 square is also 4. So basically here this is the case of many one. You can simply check according to the given data also. Means you can take any of the real number and square of every real number will be positive, you know very well. So you can take one negative part, one positive part, and fx equals to given as x square. So you can take here minus 2, minus 2 square is 4 and plus 2 square is also 4. So this is always said to be the many one function. Is it to be clear? So definitely student, you can just check in a very systematic way, and this is the very first method in which you can use the proper chain of checking testing process either the given function is said to be one one or not. Is it to be clear? Suppose one more example we have to take here. Suppose f is to be given from R to R again. Now we have to say that fx equals to x cube. Fx is to be given as x cube, and we have to check whether the given function is one one or not. So definitely we have to take the two real number, x1, x2 belongs to the real number, and such that f of x1 equals to, you can take f of x2. Now if we have to simplify this part, then x1 cube equals to x2 cube. Now as per the definition we have to use the expression. Is it to be clear? Now student, the very important thing here, cube is to be there, means for the some old power always both the things are to be found to be same, because any number is negative then its cube will be negative, any number is positive then its cube will be positive, means no cube will be either give the answer as plus or minus. So here only the result x1 equals to x2 we will get, so it is said to be 1 1. So it is said to be 1 1. Is it to be clear? So easily student, so many questions we have to take in the exercise part also, and so many questions are to be taken in the case when we have to discuss the on to case, then we have to take the some examples also where again we have to use this particular method to check whether the given function is said to be one one or not, or many one or not. Is it to be clear? So I think this first method you will get. In the very first method, what we are saying, if we have to, any function is to be given as from a to b, then we have to take the two elements from the domain such a way that f of x1 equals to f of x2, and from this condition if we are getting x1 equals to x2, then it is said to be 1 1, otherwise it is said to be the many 1. So this particular method is to be very important for us. Generally in the various type of questions we have to use this kind of method. Is it to be clear? Now the second method we have to just start here. So the next method we have to take here, second method, and just we are discussing the testing process. So the second method we are taking, graphical method. You can say that this method is known as the graphical method. Is it to be clear? Suppose any of the graph is to be given, and this particular graph is suppose any function is to be there, then how we will check whether it is one one or not? Then student, any line, if you can say that if any line parallel to x-axis, now any line parallel to x-axis, in case of function student, remember we are drawing any line parallel to y-axis, and in the case of one one, if any line parallel to x-axis intersect the graph at more than, or you can say that at exactly one point, then it is said to be one one. it is said to be 1 1. Otherwise it is many one. It is many one. Is it to be clear? So what we have to say, that for the 1 1 graphical method says that if any line parallel to x axis we are drawing, and if the graph will be intersected that line by exactly at one point, then it is said to be 1 1. Otherwise it is said to be the many one function. So basically what we are saying that suppose we have to take an example here. Suppose any of the function, or you can make the trigonometric function again sine x. This is y axis and this is x axis, and this is pi by 2, this is pi, and this is highest value is plus 1, lowest value is minus 1, like this. Is it to be clear? So student, suppose this particular function fx equals to sine x we have to define, and the domain of this function is R, and here the codomain is to be given as minus 1 to plus 1. Suppose this function is to be given here. Now for the function part, student, this is not very, this one is the very important part. So whenever we have to write any of the function, then we have to mention this part always, because without using this part we cannot plot the graph and we cannot treat the particular function. Is it to be clear? So suppose we have to check whether the given function is 1 1 or not. So basically what we are saying, if we are drawing any line parallel to x axis, so suppose we are drawing any line parallel to x axis, so student, this particular line parallel to x axis will intersect at more than one point. Is it to be clear? So if this function is said to be, then it is said to be many one. It is not 1 1, it is said to be many one. Is it to be clear? So this is the very important and graphical manner in which you can decide whether the given function is said to be the many one or 1 1. So suppose we have to take another example, and here we have to take the fx equals to log of x. Suppose the base of log is to be taken as x. Then this log function is to be again very important for us, because in the differentiation or in the entire calculus part, this log will be very important for us. So basically any base is to be defined for any of the log, and generally we have to take the base value as greater than 1. There are two cases in the log function. Sometime we have to take the less than 1, or some many of the time we have to take the greater than 1. So basically here just we want to know about the graph of this function, x axis, y axis. So the graph of log function should be like this. So the graph of this log function should be like this. This line is parallel to this y axis now, and this point is said to be the 1, 0. Now we have to check whether the given function is said to be the 1, 1 or not. So basically what we are doing, we are just drawing any line parallel to x axis, and you can draw anywhere. You can draw anywhere. This is the freedom. You can draw anywhere any line parallel to x axis. Then if it will intersect the graph exactly at one point, then we can say that it is said to be 1 1. It is said to be 1 1. So basically student, there are so many graphs, you know very well, and according to the graph, suppose anyone else asks about the condition of 1 1, then you can just provide the answer in a very simplest way. You are drawing any line parallel to x axis, and if that line will intersect the graph at exactly one point, then it is said to be the 1 1. Otherwise that line is said to be that particular function is said to be the many one. So basically we have to use this second graphical method also, because this graphical method is the very important part for you. Is it to be clear? And the third method is to be again very important, because in the third method, student, we are saying that the process of differentiation, as in class 11th, you have to know about the differentiation of the function, because some of the questions you have already discussed in the class 11th also. So this will be the based on the differentiation part. And a very important thing, just we want to say that only two method you can use up to till the date, because here student, you not know very well about the application of derivative. In the third approach, just we are saying that the increasing or strictly increasing or strictly decreasing functions theory is to be used for checking the 1 1 function. Is it to be clear? So that I will tell just only the method. Is it to be clear? So the third method I will tell just after you have to note it down the things written on the board. So pause the video to note it down. After that we will start the third method, but third method we are not using still, because here
we are not knowing about the application of derivative, but we have to keep in mind this thing. After in chapter number 6 we have to discuss that theory, then definitely student you can use that method also here. So pause the video to note it down. After that we will start the next third method, and you can say that the third method, you are saying that if any function, you are saying that if any function is strictly increasing, you can say that if any function is strictly increasing or strictly decreasing, strictly, here both the arrow symbol will represent increasing or decreasing. You have to keep in mind this thing. So if any function is strictly increasing or strictly decreasing, then it is said to be 1-1. It is always said to be 1-1. Always said to be 1-1. Is it to be clear? So this is the third method, student. But here you cannot use still till the strictly increasing concept or strictly decreasing concept. So basically, student, any function, you can remember this thing, any function is said to be strictly increasing if f dash of x is greater than 0. F dash x means the derivative of fx. The derivative of fx or the differentiation of fx is said to be the f dash x. That should be greater than 0. And second thing, we are saying that any function is said to be strictly decreasing if f dash of x is less than 0. So these things, student, we have to discuss when we have to see the basic application part of the derivative, then we have to define this thing. Till that, student, you have to keep in mind the things that are to be understood by the concept of third method. Means if any, suppose we are taking any exponential function fx equals to e raised to power x. This is called as the exponential function, and this will be defined from R positive union 0. Is it to be clear? So basically, student, here suppose we have to just plot the graph here. Just we have to plot the graph, then the graph of this function should be like this, and this point is said to be the 0, 1. Now you can say that strictly increasing or strictly decreasing means suppose we are increasing the value of x, then y will be always increasing, never be decreasing. Is it to be clear? So for increment of x, if y will be increases always, then it is said to be the strictly increasing function. Is it to be clear? So basically here the graph is also to be available, so you can use either of the graphical method or either of the f dash x. Is it to be clear? So you can say that here f dash x, and I think each and every student know very well, the differentiation of e raised to power x is always said to be the e raised to power x, and for all x belongs to real number, e raised to power x is said to be the greater than 0. So it is strictly increasing function. So it is strictly increasing function. And so it is strictly increasing function, then you can say that this function is always said to be the 1-1. So it is 1-1. So it is 1-1. Is it to be clear? So student, the third method is still, suppose some time of that differentiation problem is to be there, some time other, but these type of differentiation and remaining problems we have to solve in the entire calculus, then definitely this third method will be more useful to each and every student. So there are three methods to check whether the given function is said to be the 1-1 or not. Is it to be clear? And regularly, student, for the 1-1 we have to just discuss about the many one also. Suppose any of the function is 1-1, then it should not be many one. And suppose it is not 1-1, then definitely it should be the many one function. Is it to be clear? So this is the very basic testing process of 1-1 function. Now we will start the next type of testing, that should be on behalf of onto function. Is it to be clear? So first of all, we have to see the onto function. After that, how the onto part is to be get checked, we have to see this thing. Is it to be clear? So pause the video to note it down. After that, you will start the next part. Next one is the onto function. So basically, student, what should be the basic definition of onto? First of all, we have to understand this thing. Then after, we have to see the basic testing process of the onto function. Is it to be clear? And the corresponding checking of into function will be automatically to be done, because any of the function, when we are saying that it is said to be the onto, then that function never be taken as the into function. Is it to be clear? So there should be no requirement to check the into function. So what should be the basic definition of onto? First of all, we have to say this thing. So we are saying that if any of the function will be defined from A set to B set, then A is said to be the domain element and B is said to be the codomain. So any of the function will be defined, suppose, from A set to B set, then this is said to be the codomain. And for the onto function, what we have to check? We have to say that if each and every codomain element of set B is the codomain here, then each and every codomain element has its preimage, then it is said to be onto function. Otherwise, it is not said to be the onto function. So we are saying that in any function, if codomain elements has its preimage in domain, then it is said to be onto function. So this is the very basic definition, student. One more definition you can provide here. Suppose we can say that any of the function, suppose we have to take this example to understand this definition. Suppose any function is to be defined from A to B, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here A, B, C, D and E, suppose. Is it to be clear? Here the function is to be defined like this. Is it to be clear? Now, first of all, you can check whether it is a function or not. So basically, suppose just we want to tell the domain of this particular function, then domain will be set A. Here, suppose we have to discuss about the codomain, then you can say that the codomain of this function will be set B. Or in set A, all the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, and in the codomain A, B, C, D, and E, suppose just we have to discuss about the range. Then range is what? Range is always said to be the subset of codomain. So basically, here the range part is to be there, then A, B, C, and D. So in the range part only, we have to discuss the A, B, C, and D. Means these four elements are to be considered in the range part. Is it to be clear? So first of all, we have to discuss about the domain, codomain and range part. Now, if we have to prove, we have to check whether the given function is onto or not, then one important section we have to discuss here. Students, suppose we are just proving, we are interested in proving codomain and range equal. Then suppose any of the function has its same range and same codomain, then it is again said to be the onto function. So we are saying that if codomain is equals to range, then it is said to be onto function. So this is the another definition, onto function. So this is the another definition. Suppose sometime we are just interested to proving the relation between codomain and range, then for the onto function, if you are proving the codomain equals to range, means codomain of F equals to the range of F, then in this case, this given function is said to be onto. Is it to be clear? So both the definitions are to be the very important for us. Now student, suppose here, we have to take an example. Suppose any of the function is to be written like this, 1, 2, 3, 4. And here A set is to be given and another set B is to be given as A, B, C, D and E.
Now suppose the relation or function is to be given like this. Is it to be clear? Now first of all, this function will be, this is the function or not? So definitely student, it should be the function, because each and every codomain element has exactly one image. So this is the function. Now we have to check whether it is 1 1 or not. First of all, we have to check whether it is 1 1 or not. So one element of domain element has exactly one image. It is 1 1. It is 1 1. There should be no problem to understand this thing. Now for the onto, what we will check? We will check whether each and every codomain element has its pre-image or not. According to the first definition, we are saying that for any function, if codomain elements has its pre-image in domain, then it is said to be the onto function. Means we have to check the means pre-image of A will be A1, pre-image of B will be 2, pre-image C will be 3, pre-image of D will be 4, but no pre-image of this element E will be there. So it is not onto. It is not onto. Is it to be clear? It is not onto. Means you can say that it is into function. It is into function. Because suppose any of the function is not onto, then it is said to be the into function. Is it to be clear? So basically, student, the definition of onto function will be clear to each and every student. And there are two most important definitions just we have to discussing here. Any of the function, if codomain elements has its pre-image in domain, then it is said to be the onto. Otherwise, we have to just prove that codomain equals to the range. Then both the definitions are to be the very similar, and you can just check whether the given function is said to be the 1 1 or onto or not. Is it to be clear? To understand this thing in more systematic way, we have to take the some different examples, and according to that we have to just say whether the given function is said to be the 1 1 onto or not. So pause the video to note it down. Then after, we will start the next example. Next example we are taking here. Suppose any of the function f will be defined from natural number to natural number, and we have to take fx equals to x square. We have to check whether the function is said to be the 1 1 or not, or onto or not. Is it to be clear? So firstly, we have to check for the 1 1. We have to check for the 1 1. So we can say that let x1 comma x2 belongs to the natural number such that f of x1 equals to f of x2. Again, we are taking the same example here. So x1 square equals to x2 square, but student, x1 and x2 are natural number. So we are not writing here plus minus x2. Only we have to write the x1 equals to x2, because x1 and x2 is what? x1 and x2 both are said to be the natural number, and natural number cannot be negative here. So we can say that, so it is 1 1. So it is 1 1. Is it to be clear? Next, suppose we are just checking the onto function, then how this type of processing of onto is to be done? So first of all, let f of x equals to y. Suppose first of all, we have to understand this particular f of x will be taken as y. Then fx is what? X square. So we can say that x square equals to y. Then we will write the value of x. X equals to plus minus root y or plus root y. Basically, student, here x belongs to the natural number, means x is a positive number. So we will write only the x equals to root of y. Is it to be clear? So basically, student, in this case, why we are not writing here plus minus? This will depend on the particular x. And here x means the domain, and domain is the natural number, and natural number will have to be negative. That's why we are not taking a plus or minus. Is it to be clear? Now we will check y belongs to the natural number, because the codomain of this particular function will belong to the natural number also here. So y belongs to the natural number, then we have to check x belongs to the natural number or not. So you can say that for all y belongs to the natural number, x does not belong to the natural number. Because suppose we are taking 2 belongs to the natural number. 2 belongs to the natural number. But if we have to put the value of y, equals to 2 here, then root 2 does not belong to the natural number. So it is not onto. It is not onto. Is it to be clear? So basically, student, if we have to just prove it is not onto, then only one example is to be sufficient here. Suppose we are saying that for all y belongs to natural number, x does not belong to. This thing will be specified by using this example.
suppose we are taking any of the natural number. Why we are taking natural number? Because the codomain means we are taking any of the element will from the codomain. Then you can check whether the square root of this, because here the codomain will be y, and we have to put the value of y here. Then root 2 does not belong to the natural number. Definitely, if for any of one number it is false, then always it is said to be not onto. Is it to be clear? Means what we have to say? We can say that this particular function is said to be the into function. Is it to be clear? So in this way, student, just we can think about the particular onto part. We will take one more example here. Suppose any of the function f, and that should be taken from real number to natural number. And fx equals to, suppose we are taking the x square. Now we have to change the domain here. Now what will be the answer of 1 1 and onto? So firstly we have to check for the 1 1 function. So for 1 1 we are saying that let x1 comma x2 belongs to the real number now, because from the domain we are taking the two element, or we can say that such that f of x1 equals to f of x2. Now x1 square equals to x2 square. And real numbers are to be there, then we can say that x1 equals to plus or minus x2. So it is not 1 1. So it is not 1 1. Not 1 1 means we can say that this function is said to be the many one function. Is it to be clear? So the very basic part, because on behalf of these real numbers, you are using here plus minus. Is it to be clear? Now, second thing we have to just check for the onto function. Then for onto, always we have to take f of x equals to y, and we can say that fx equals to x square equals to y, and x will be, now we have to write the plus or minus root y, because here just x will belong to the real number, and real number can be either positive or negative. That's why we are taking here plus or minus. Now student, for all y belongs to the natural number. Means y is always positive number. Definitely x belongs to the real number, because you can take any of the natural number here, because in the case of real number, all the kind of numbers are to be included. So basically student, here x equals to plus minus root y. Suppose we are taking any of the natural number 1 2 3 4 5, then root 2 root 3 root 4 root 5 root 6, any of the real number, any of the natural number will be substituted here for y, then definitely you will get the real number, because in the real number all the type of number, means you can say that for whole codomain pre-image will be existed in the domain. So it is onto. So it is onto function. Is it to be clear? So basically student, here in this example, this particular example specifies that it is onto function. So for the onto, what we have to check? We have to check the for each and every codomain element, the pre-image will be existed or not. If for any of the one element is there for which the pre-image does not exist, then it is not said to be onto. In that case, it is said to be the into function. Is it to be clear? So student, these are the basic theory related to the 1 1 function and onto function. Automatically, many one or into will be checked. There should be no problem to check in the processing of many one or into functions. Is that to be clear? And one more important thing, if any of the function that should be 1 1 as well as onto, then it is said to be the bijective function. Is it to be clear? So in this video student, just we have to discuss about the basic testing process of onto, into, various type of definitions of into or onto. We have to see this thing. Is it to be clear? So each and everything we have to keep in mind. Then in the next video, just we will start the exercise 1.2, where definitely student, we are doing the various type of questions, and in that type of questions always we have to just use the testing process of 1 1 function and onto function. Sometimes some graphical approach we have to use, sometimes some basic theoretical approach we have to use. So each and every question we have to solve of your NCERT exercise 1.2 in the next video. Then you can see again the basic concept if you are not understanding, but I think each and every student will getting the concept, and each and every student will getting the concept of 1 1 or onto function here. Is it to be clear? So thank you student. In next video we will meet with the NCERT exercise 1.2 related to the functions. Thank you.